Good morning, and happy Easter Sunday.
Happy Easter.
Welcome to Church of the Ascension. My name is Lita Simbilan. We especially welcome those who might be visiting us or joining us in person for the first time since the pandemic began. We are so happy to have you with us. Announcements. Today's Mass is being streamed live. We are united today, both in person and with our online family. For those present with us, please silence your cell phones at this time, and you are welcome to sing along while wearing your mask. We invite you to visit our website, ascensionvb.org. There you can view our bulletin, sign up for weekly emails, find sacrament information, locate a link to view Mass online, and find more information about our wonderful parish. Please rise for our gathering song.
Jesus Christ is risen today.
And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, first of all, I would like to say Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Dear friends, as we celebrate Easter today, we thank God for the gift of faith, and we thank God for the gift of peace. Easter reminds us the way Jesus He was resurrected in the way he appeared in our lives in a different environment. Today, in a very special way, we hear Peter, Mary, Magdalene, and John. They were surprised to see that Jesus was not in the tomb. But through their faith and their acceptance and readiness to follow what he told them, they continue to be strengthened by the risen Christ. We are here to continue to be strengthened by the risen Christ, to love one another and to support one another, but at the same time to continue to reconcile one another. Easter without reconciling one another, that's not Easter. And Easter without taking care of one another, that's not Easter, but Easter for peace also. Coming together as God's family, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's love and mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace.
O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened to all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. "Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory." The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord is with you.
With your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Please be seated. Christos Anesti. Alithos Anesti. This is the Easter greeting in Greek, meaning Christ has risen. He is risen indeed. And so after having studied ancient Greek for a couple of years long ago, I've really wanted to proclaim this for many, many years. It's the first time I've done it. Yeah. I've also been fortunate and honored to have had the opportunity to preach for more than 18 years here at Ascension. But this is a first, a very special first, not just the Greek, but this is the first time that I've ever preached on Easter Sunday, the pinnacle of our liturgical year, a commemoration of the greatest event in the history of mankind, resurrection, the promise of eternal life, God's greatest gift to mankind. Wow. Wow. I think you all know, when you've heard me preach in the past, that I really like to tell stories in my homilies. Here's a couple. The late Catholic Archbishop of Hartford, Connecticut, John Whalen, had undergone cancer surgery resulting in a permanent colostomy when he wrote these very personal words in one of his last Easter messages. "I am now a member of an association of people who have been wounded by cancer. That association has as its symbol the phoenix, a bird of Egyptian mythology. The Greek poet Hesiod, who lived 8 centuries before Christ was born, wrote about this legendary bird in his poetry. When the bird felt his death was near, every 500 to 1500 years, it would fly off to Phoenicia, build a nest of aromatic wood, and set itself on fire. When the bird was consumed by the flames, a new phoenix struck forth from the ashes. Thus the phoenix symbolized immortality, resurrection, and life after death." This sums up the Easter message perfectly. Jesus gave up his life, and from the grave he was raised to life again on the third day. New life rises from the ashes of death. Today we're celebrating Christ's victory over the grave, the gift of eternal life for all who believe in Jesus. That's why the phoenix was one of the earliest symbols of the risen Christ. The phoenix also symbolizes our daily rising to new life. Every day, like the phoenix, we rise from the ashes of sin and guilt and are refreshed and renewed by our living Lord and Savior with his forgiveness and the assurance that he still loves us and will continue to give us the strength we need. Archbishop Wayland, could have lived a gloomy tomb of self-pity, hopeless defeat, and chronic sadness. But his faith in the risen Lord opened his eyes to a new vision of life. In 1887, 22 years after the assassination of President Abraham Lincoln, his coffin was dug up and opened because there were constant rumors that his body was not in the grave. So they dug it up, and the body was there. The rumors continued, so 14 years later, they had to dig it up again. Both times, witnesses were there and were present and testified that Lincoln was still in the grave. 3 days after the death of Jesus, similar rumors began to be spread throughout the land of Israel. Only this time, there were no witnesses who could say that they had seen his body. In fact, to the contrary, many witnesses claimed to have seen him out of his grave and even talked to him after the resurrection. As great a man as Lincoln was, there were witnesses to prove that he was still in the grave. If one of our presidents or another leader in our government were to cry out to Lincoln for help, there would be no response. If a scientist were to cry out to Einstein to help today, there would only be empty silence. If someone were to call out to Muhammad or Buddha or Gandhi, there would be no help. But if you and I call out to Jesus Christ, there is an instant power available to us, power to change lives. Why? Because he lives. My brothers and sisters, this long year has felt like we've been locked in, not just restricted to our homes because of the pandemic, locked in because we can't break a habit. We're confined by sickness or disability. The death of a loved one can cast Good Friday shadow over the rest of our lives, the natural world crumbling into an environment of Good Fridays. Nations are tearing themselves up, even within their own borders. We can feel locked up in a Good Friday world almost without an easy escape device to get us out. Jesus was defeated, killed, and locked behind a heavy stone. I don't know if there were two men in white or one, as one of the other gospel accounts refer, or if they were there. What we believe is that while it was still dark in the world, God released Jesus from the tomb. There is no quick and easy escape device for us for a lot of the situations we find ourselves in these days. But because what God did for Jesus, we believe God can also do for us. Maybe not instantly, but step by step, from the dark of any tomb, little by little, into the light of Easter Sunday. Good Friday may continue for us for a while, but today reminds us that God has won the final victory. What if someone were to say, "Prove it"? Well, we just can't from those very familiar gospel accounts. No one actually saw Jesus rise. What we have is an empty tomb and their word, "Prove it." We can't. The resurrection was the only event in Jesus' life that was entirely between him and God. I can't prove the resurrection. I can't explain it. I can't force it to make any sense. What we can say is, "I believe. I trust it. I will live my life in the light of the resurrection." Haven't we experienced it more than once when Good Friday became Easter Sunday? We believe that on the other side of death and pain is always resurrection, always new creation, always new life. It is not Good Friday forever, but it is Easter Sunday forever. Christos Anesti, Alathos Anesti. He has risen indeed. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that you may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And now I would like to ask you to stand, and I'm going to ask you a few questions. Just say, I do. Do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, and in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
Petitions to our loving God, who gave up his own Son to give us eternal life.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, Bishop Nestaut, Father Daniel, and our deacons, may they be renewed by the power of the risen Christ and remain in good health as they share his message of love to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have come into full communion with the Catholic Church and celebrate sacrament this Easter day through the rite of initiation, may their faith and desire grow even stronger. Sustain them throughout their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the miracle of the resurrection will fill the Church, empowering each Christian to spread the good news of the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of the risen Christ, which surpasses understanding, wash over our nation and world, bringing unity and harmony. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all seeking prayer, our healthcare professionals be given strength, those economically displaced find comfort, those who are in poor health with acute or chronic illness, especially our loved ones who we name now. May they find healing this Easter season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Christ, who suffered death out of love for us, bring eternal life to those who have died, especially Sally King, the mother of Cindy Loffer, and Mary Ann DeLuca. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, we glory in the cross and rejoice in the empty tomb, which proclaims salvation and eternal life. Hear our humble prayer and remember all of our needs through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners, and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightfully gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Barry, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracious grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us now offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for just a moment. Again, thank you for gathering here on this incredible high holy day of the church, the Easter Sunday, together with our pastor, Father Daniel, and the other deacons, Deacon Gary, Deacon Jim, Father Joe, our retired priest that's with us. We wish you all a very absolutely wonderful, holy, fulfilling, safe, and healthy Easter. The list could go on and on. Normally, we invite visitors or people that are new to the church to stand and tell us our name and where you're from, but we don't do that today because we'd never get out of here on time. We have a lot of folks. If you are visiting or you don't get to church very often, the invitation is always there to please come join us, especially things, hopefully at some time in the not-too-distant future, things will relax a little bit. We can get a full choir going and really get the powerful music that we're so well-known for. Yes. Father, any last comments from you?
No. Good. Thank you so much.
Let us now stand and bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And your response is Amen. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
This Mass is ending. We go now in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Center of the broken face. Now the Easter.